Now, a brand new year is just around the corner. It's a chance for many to start fresh in all aspects of their lives. That includes one's financial health. Let's get some advice or insight on how to save or to put your money in 2024 with Mr. Efren Cruz. He is the chairman and CEO of Personal Finance Advisors Philippines Corporation. Good morning, Efren. Merry Christmas. Happy to talk to you again.
Good morning and Merry Christmas to you.
All right, Efren, you know, coming in from 3 years of pandemic, people may have depleted savings already or in debt, in fact, if you talk about revenge spending in the last few months, losing jobs or income and businesses. If 2024 is now a year of recovery, as many are hoping, where do we begin? You know, you have paying debt, saving, investing. Which one comes first?
If you have debt. The obvious answer to that is to pay down your debt, because you save, you're not going to earn much on that. Better to pay your debt so that you cut back on interest expense.
All right. And of course, following that, of course, after paying your debt, you save and then you invest. How are things looking on those fronts in 2024?
Actually, in terms of investments, there's a lot of opportunity out there. As you said, it's a period of recovery, though. Not just for the Philippines, but also the global economy. So it will be best that you have budgeted already for your operating expenses, and then there is an amount that you will really invest, not touch, just invest, and let it sit there for a while.
All right. So debt service is really a priority now. Debt may be a special concern, especially during these times of inflation and even high interest rates. That's why you're recommending, of course, to prioritize paying those debts. Surprisingly, credit companies also saw a surge in credit card usage in the first half of 2023 alone. We saw the rise, about 39% in credit card user base, also seeing a rise of 12%. Now, this may be good news for banks, but worrisome in terms of the borrower's general financial health. Now, how must one view debt, and how do you pay your credit card bills?
Well, we have this thing which we call the reality cash flow. What you need to do is just be aware of how cash moves in your finances. Okay. If you borrow, then your cash on hand goes up, right? But you're going to also have to spend that. Hopefully you borrow because you're going to spend it on something. We don't really recommend borrowing and just investing into financial securities.
Okay.
So if you are aware of that, you know that every time you spend, you feel the pain of losing money. We're loss averse. So if you have a budget, really tracks that, you'll be more cautious with how money flows out. You'll be more conservative how money flows in. And that's really a basic that we should learn. Awareness of how money flows in our finances.
And you run an advocacy to help people get out of debt. What is the situation on the ground now? I mean, do you see more Filipinos with credit problems? And perhaps can you share with us what the common circumstances or situations are that you could cite or that you have encountered?
Okay. The most common one is that people who run out of cash will go to lenders.
Right.
Who can lend you with not much credit check. Mm-hmm. Of course, they will check high interest rates. And they will. The bad thing is that they will require payment 7 days later or 14 days later. But if you're feeling a cash crunch, it's highly unlikely that you'll have cash to pay in the next 7 days or 14 days. But we really tell people, try not to do that. Try to borrow from the banks. Try to borrow from the usual lenders, huh? Because their interest rates are manageable.
Okay, and aren't you seeing those numbers, I mean, those people going to informal channels to borrow money increasing as well, decreasing, in fact, considering that, you know, there are a lot of ways, a lot of formal financial channels you can borrow from. You have the e-wallets even offering the loan services. Now, are Filipinos still prone to borrowing through informal channels?
Yes, they are. They are. Well, from friends, all the way up to the, shall we say, the unregistered loan sharks.
Right.
And my God, when problems arise, you know, it's so difficult to manage them because they're not covered by regulation. So it's like he said, she said, you know, you go to the barangay, it goes to the courts and everything, you're harassed. So you really tell people, just go through the registered form of channels of lending instead of just going to these, we call them utang sa tao.
Right. utang sa tao. And then when you are overwhelmed, in fact, it is so difficult to really prioritize or even wrap your mind around paying those debts given what you earn. What kind of clarity can you provide now to those who are drowning in debt? I mean, how should they see things? How do you prioritize under these circumstances?
Well, first things first, you have to take an account of all of what you borrow and the interest costs, no? The interest rates. Try to prioritize paying down those that cost more. Okay. The other thing is that we do have what we call the Financial Rehabilitation and Insolvency Act. There's a way to actually go to the courts and get reprieve from, not reprieve, but you know, to be able to manage the payments of your debts. But the best way really is to just talk to them, and ask for a restructuring or get refinancing from some other new creditor.
All right, from debts, Efren, we go now to savings. Are you seeing a rise in savings as well now, given that, you know, as I mentioned earlier, government is pushing for financial inclusion, going full throttle this time with fintechs, even digital banks, reaching out aggressively to the unbanked, encouraging them to save. Is that making a dent, in fact, in the way Filipinos put away money for the future?
Right now, what we're seeing is that it's more easy for people to borrow than to save.
Okay.
That's what's up.
Okay.
So, really tell people, convenience is the one that wreaks havoc in your finances. If you're going to save, put it in an account that has high penalty rates for withdrawing early.
Okay.
So that you don't really just put and withdraw money right away. It's good that some digital banks are offering high interest rates. That's also a good incentive for people to put their money there.
Okay, of course, we know for a fact that it's useless to save and not grow one's money in the process as well, which brings us to investments. There are several investment instruments out there that suit various capacities and even risk appetites, if you will. Now, which ones must one pursue that could offer capital growth and at the same time preservation? Because, you know, these are uncertain times. Everything is very volatile. When you talk about high-risk assets, you know, the risk or the chances of losing what you have invested is there. So what can you advise investors or those savers that are planning to invest, how to thread these difficult times, volatile times?
Oh, okay. Simple. Don't run after the high returns, because high returns obviously have higher risk. Hmm. All investments are good. You just have to ask yourself what good an investment, a particular investment, can do for you. Even a time deposit that pays a lower rate than compared to a stock market investment, time deposit has its purpose.
Okay.
So you have to look at your finances and see what you really need to earn for the particular needs you have in the future and in the short term, and allocate accordingly.
All right. And of course, succeeding in all of those saving and investing depends really on how much money you put aside, which is also controlled by the way you spend money. Let's talk about spending now, the habits of Filipinos. These days, you know, purchases are made easier and faster because of digital shopping. The platforms are there compared to the past when you had to go physically to the stores for these purchases. Now, what caveat or even tips can you offer to those who cannot get hold of themselves whenever there is or they feel a need, a compulsion to spend money?
Okay. Number one, if you can, don't maintain ATM accounts. Maintain passbook accounts.
Okay.
So that you really see readily that the money is there.
Okay.
When you see that it's been accumulating, and because it's so difficult to withdraw, you have to call in line, you'll see the money build up. And you'll be more hesitant to withdraw and reduce that amount of money. Secondly, if you're going to buy something, try to do it in person.
Okay.
Rather than it online, because it's so convenient. Nakahiga ka lang, buy something.
Yeah, as opposed going to the bank and, you know, queuing up for your passbook accounts to transact in those accounts. Now, Efren, 2024 is upon us now, and financial health, of course, could be a common New Year's resolution, as it is always at the start of the year, which we could all hope could be sustained as well for the next 12 months. Now, what is your advice when considering these financial resolutions? What tips can you give our viewers?
Very simple, budget. Budget not only money that comes in, but money especially that flows out.
Okay.
Because, you know, when you store, it's so easy to say, this is cheaper than the other. It's easy to do window shopping.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't figure out how it's going to impact your cash flow in the near term, in the future. So if you actually look at the total picture, then you'll be more, you know, more circumspect with how you handle your money. So budget the entirety, not only money coming in, but also money going out.
All right, Efren, you know, under your group, you have a lot of advocacies. What can you do, what you do, and how can one get better financial guidance that they need through your platform? One of those advocacies, of course, is getting people out of debt. What else is there that you offer?
Oh, we also offer advice to people in terms of how they manage their actual portfolios. If they're invested in financial securities, we give them a comprehensive financial plan, lots of that. But you can actually just go to the internet and Google ask a friend. Okay. We'll be ready to help out for free.
All right. On that note, Mr. Efren Cruz, Chairman and CEO of Personal Finance Advisors of the Philippines Corporation, thank you so much for talking to us today. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year as well. Thank you.